Hello everyone, today we will teach you how to install the CO2 glass laser tube and how to replace it, how to maintain it. First, we need to open the laser tube cabinet, which is normally located at the back of your CO2 laser machine. For our customers who are using large size laser machines, the cabinet may be located at the top of the gantry or sides of the machine body.
We are going to put the laser tube in place over these two brackets. Keep the laser window facing the reflection mirror. Leave a space of about 50 to 100 mm. Level the laser tube by adjusting the height of the brackets. Then we can use the Allen key to tighten the socket head screws. You can move this part of the bracket upward to downward and side to side, so as to fix the laser tube and aim the laser beam from laser tube to the reflector 1. Now we will connect the laser tube to the water chiller. The water inlet is the side with the high voltage cable. The water outlet is the side next to the reflection mirror. Plug in the water pipe to both sides and use a cable tie to tighten the water pipe.
You can check out our water chiller installation video to learn how to connect the other side of the water pipe to the water chiller.
After you're done, we will connect the high voltage wire and the ground wire. The high voltage cable is the one with red color. We will thread each red wire into the silicone cable. Then we twist the two wires by hand and make sure they are touching close and solid. Plug the silicone cable into the plastic white cover.
You can use electrical tape to fix the high voltage wire around the laser tube and make sure they stay in a good isolation space like shown in the picture.
The ground wire is on the other side with black color. We will use a screwdriver to tighten the ground wire. Then you are all set.
Besides the 100-watt laser tube installation, we also offer high-power DC glass laser tube like 300 watts, 450 watts, and 600 watts, and RF laser tube options. The installation is quite different. We will explain more in other videos. Subscribe and stay tuned. If you want to replace a new laser tube in any case, you should power off your CO2 laser and water chiller first.
To disassemble the laser tube, we need to use the Allen key to unscrew the socket head screws. There are supposed to be 4 of them. Then we use a screwdriver to disconnect the ground wire and remove the water out connection. Use the scissors to cut the cable tie and pull out the water pipe from the liquid nozzle of the laser tube. It will drain the water down from the water in because of the air pressure. Now let's move to the other side of the laser tube. Pull out the silicone cover and touch the high power cable to the machine body to release any free voltage. Twist the cable and take out the silicone cover. Leave it to the side. Use your two hands to lift the glass laser tube. Elevate one side inclined about 30 degrees so the water can drain out to the water chiller from the pipe. Wait until the water is drained, pull out the water pipe and you are all set.
Now you can install a new CO2 laser tube as we showed in the first part of the video. Every time you install a new one, you should always test it before going into actual production. You should also make sure there's no flowing bubble in your glass laser tube, especially near the water outlet nozzle. The bubbles will cause local heating of the glass tube and cause cracking. Regarding the maintenance of your glass laser tube, there are 3 things you need to pay attention to. First, use a lint-free towel to clean the glass tube regularly. There is a high voltage wire near the laser tube. Every time you use a laser machine, a magnetic field will be formed around the high voltage wire to produce an electrostatic absorption effect, so the dust in the air will be absorbed on the laser tube. Secondly, change the water in your water chiller monthly. The cloudy liquid will have a hard time cooling the laser tube. Lastly, remember to add antifreeze liquid into your water chiller in the winter to protect your glass laser tube.
Thanks for watching. Also, we have made a series of videos about CO2 laser guides and tutorials. If you are interested, check them out. And don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next video.